Hello, I am Dr. Babu Vishas from PN Das College. Today we will learn how to solve partial differential equation of first order by Lagrange's method. The differential equation is of the form PP plus QQ equal to R, where P equal to del Z del X, Q equal to as usual del Z del Y, and capital P, Q, R are functions of X, Y and Z. One thing we should keep in mind that Z is a dependent variable and X and Y are independent variables. We will go to the working rule. Now, working rule. Step 1, put the differential equation in the form dx by capital P equal to dy by capital Q equal to dz by capital R. Step 2. In step 2, step 1, put the equation in the form PP Q equal to R as above. Step 2 is find the auxiliary equation of the form dx by capital P, dy by capital Q and dz by capital R. This auxiliary equation is also called Lagrange's auxiliary equation. Now, step 3. In step 3, find two solutions from the simultaneous equation 2 as U x y z equal to c1 and V x y z equal to c2, where c1 and c2 are constants, and we can find these two solutions by taking any two combination. You can take these two or first and last relation or combination of three. So we have two solutions U and V from these ratios. Now, this is the last step. Step 4. The general solution is actually, we may write the general solution in three forms. Either this is phi of u be equal to 0, or u equal to phi of v, or v equal to phi of u, where phi is an arbitrary function. Actually, there are three types of problem may arise, and there are three different ways to solve this problem using this method. Okay, so I will describe these one by one. Type 1. The main task is to find two solutions from the auxiliary equation. So in type 1, we will discuss that in case of in case of first integral or first solution, one variable may be absent or cancels out from the two ratios, and in case of the second solution, same situation arises. Let us take an example. Let y square z by x p equal to z, plus zx equal to y square. This is here q. This is the given equation. Then what is the auxiliary equation? The auxiliary equation is, you see, this is dx by y square z by x equal to dy by, this is the q term, zx equal to dz by, this is r term, y square. This is 2. Now, firstly, I will choose these two equations, these two ratios from first and second relation. We have dx by y square z by x equal to dy by zx. In this case, you see that z can be cancelled out. This implies dx by y square by x equal to dy by x, or on simplification, it is x square dx minus y square dy equal to 0. Integrating, we have x cube minus y square y cube equal to c1. c1 is a arbitrary constant. Okay. And in case we have to find the another solution, if we choose the first relation and third relation from first and third relation, we have y square may be cancelled out, and it is x dx minus z dz equal to 0. Integrating, we have x square minus z square equal to c2, where c2 is again a constant. Okay, so we have two solutions here. This is 3 and this is 4. One thing we should remember, that these two solutions may be independent, or one solution may be obtained using the other solution. Okay, so we have two solutions. If you say this is u and this is v, then therefore the general solution is phi of, from 3 and 4 we can get the solution, x cube minus y cube एक्स स्क्वायर होयर फाइज एंड एनी आर्बिट्रारी फंक्शन. सो दिस इज द फंक्शन ऑफ एक्स क्यूब माइनस वाई क्यूब एंड एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस जेड. प्रॉब्लम इन टाइप टू प्रॉब्लम दिस इज सेम एज द फर्स्ट केस फर्स्ट टाइप फॉर फर्स्ट सॉल्यूशन. दिस इज टाइप टू. इन केस ऑफ फर्स्ट सॉल्यूशन इन केस ऑफ फर्स्ट सॉल्यूशन वन वेरिएबल मे बी एब्सेंट और कैंसल्स आउट फ्रॉम टू रेशियोस एंड इन 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 केस ऑफ सेकेंड सॉल्यूशन एंड इन केस ऑफ सेकेंड सॉल्यूशन द सिचुएशन इज नॉट सेम एज केस वन एज द केस ऑफ फर्स्ट सॉल्यूशन. इट मे ऑल्सो हैपन. नाउ वी विल टेक अनदर एग्जाम्पल हियर. यू सी इफ यू टेक दिस एग्जाम्पल जेड इंटू जेड स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स वाई पी एक्स माइनस क्यू वाई इक्वल टू एक्स टू द पावर फोर. दिस इज द गिवेन पार्शियल डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड वी कैन राइट दिस इन दिस फॉर्म. दिस इज जेड एक्स जेड स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स वाई पी माइनस वाई जेड इंटू जेड स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स वाई इंटू क्यू इक्वल टू एक्स टू द पावर फोर. सो दिस इज द कैपिटल पी दिस इज द कैपिटल क्यू एंड दिस इज आर. इन दिस केस द ऑक्सिलरी इक्वेशन इज dx by zx into z square plus xy equal to dy by minus yz into z square plus xy equal to dz by x to the power 4. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Now we have to find two solutions from this relation. If we choose the first two relations from first two relations, we have C dx. This term is eliminated and also z is cancelled out. So this is dx by x equal to dy by minus y. And integrating, this is simple. We have integrating, we have you can check it. This is C1. C1 is a constant. Now we have to find another solution. Taking the first and last relations, we have, see, this is dx, and we'll use this solution, first solution. Okay, we'll use this first solution, so we can write C1 in place of X1. So this is zx into z square plus C1 and dz by x to the power 4, and the variable can be separated. This implies this implies x cube dx minus z into z square plus u1 dz equal to 0. And integrating, we have, just do it, this is simple, x to the power 4 minus z to the power 4 minus 2c1 z square equal to c2. C2 is another arbitrary constant. Now, one thing we must be aware that there should not be two constants. This constant should be replaced by this term, that is x to the power 4 minus z square minus 2 into xy z square equal to c2. So we have previous solution, this is 3 and we have 4. Therefore, the general solution is phi of xy and x to the power 4 minus z square minus 2xy z square equal to 0, where phi is any arbitrary function. Okay, so this is type 2. In type 2, what we have in case of first solution, one variable has been cancelled out, and in case of second solution, it is has not been possible, but we have used the first integral in case of second solution. Okay, now we have the third type. What is the third type? You see, in type 3, this is type 3, Lagrange's auxiliary equation dx by p equal to dy by q equal to dz by r may be also be written by the using the principle of ratio proportion as dx by p equal to dy by q equal to dz by r equal to p1 dx by p1 p, and this way q1 dy, for this is q1 q, and r1 dz, and in the denominator it is R1 R. And we have another ratio, and we can choose any two ratio from here and to get the solutions. Okay, just we choose an example here. Let z into x plus y into p plus z into x minus y into q equal to x square plus y square. This is the given equation. Then Lagrange's auxiliary equation is dx, you can do it, z into x plus y equal to dy by z into x minus y equal to dz by x square plus y square. This is R. Okay. Now you see that This can be written, this is the first term, and this can be written as using the ratio proportion. This is dx minus y, sorry, this is x dx minus y dy minus z dz equal to xz into x plus y minus yz into x minus y minus z into x plus y square. This is equal to, you see, in the denominator it is 0, and x dx minus y dy minus z dz. So we are very much fortunate here, the denominator is 0. So we can write from here x dx minus y dy minus z dz equal to 0. Integrating, we have, this is very simple, x square minus y square minus z square equal to c1. C1 is an arbitrary constant. Again, we can use ratio proportion in different way. You see, this is dx by z into x plus y equal to dy by z into x minus y equal to dz by x square plus y square equal to y dx plus x dy minus z dz equal to yz x plus y plus xz x minus y minus z into x square plus y square, and this gives again the denominator is 0, so this is y dx plus x dy minus z dz. This implies y dx plus x dy minus z dz equal to 0. This equation we have y square plus x square minus z square equal to c2. C2 is again another constant. Therefore, the general solution is phi of, from this case, this is x square minus y square minus z square, and from here, this is y square plus x square minus z square equal to 0, where phi is an arbitrary function. Thank you.